There are a lot of obstacles. Sometimes diaspora populations are regarded with suspicion by people who stayed at home. They're, you know, people who got out maybe when the going was tough and didn't participate fully in national development or in politics. Of course, in many cases, the members of the diaspora didn't have much choice when they left. So sometimes there's a suspicion of their motives or their backgrounds. Other times it's just sort of a matter of different cultural acquisitions, you know, that members of the diaspora may expect things at home to be done in the way that they've become used to doing them in another country and have different ideas about what really constitutes effective communication, what constitutes efficiency, who the stakeholders are who have to be included in a discussion. So there can be misunderstandings along the way. But I think both sides of the equation, countries of origin and members of the diaspora, are making much more concerted efforts now to overcome those potential misunderstandings.